Well, something that you did 18 years ago, the Royal Rumble in 2002, your appearance, historic, goes down, a surprise appearance, of course. You were in developmental at the time, and then there he is, The Undertaker. And then you do this. You eliminate The Undertaker from the Royal Rumble. So an unbelievable moment. The crowd goes absolutely wild. You've always had them. You had them there. But how much notice did you have that you were going to be in that Royal Rumble?
Okay. You know, this is the one story. It doesn't matter who I'm meeting, whatever I'm signing at an autograph signing or whoever I'm talking to. This is the one thing that people want to talk about. And I get it. I completely understand. As you mentioned, I was in developmental. I was in Cincinnati, Ohio at HWA, Heartland Wrestling, you know, with a lot of guys that became, I mean, just WWE staples later, guys like Jamie Noble. You know, 3 Minute Warning was there. Randy Orton, Batista, John Cena, they were all, you know, an hour or two up the road at OVW at the time. I got the call literally the day before saying, you know, because Tough Enough had just ended. I think I'd been on programming probably a handful of times, maybe two or three times. I wrestled Taz a couple times. I think I wrestled Booker on SmackDown once. And the day before, they called and they were like, you're going to Atlanta, which is where the Rumble was. I flew out the next day. No clue what was going to go. At that point, you know, I'm not an idiot. I knew I'd probably be in the Rumble, but I knew I would probably, you know, come out, you know, get a quick, you know, whatever pop Tough Enough was going to give, and then I would be, you know, thrown out and gotten rid of as soon as possible. When I got there and, you know, they called me to the ring, and it was Shane and Taker. And it, can I tell this story real quick? Because it's pretty good. All right. So they called me to the ring, and at the time, I'm terrified, you know. I mean, I'm the rookie. I'm young. I mean, I'm in my, you know, mid-20s, and I'm standing there with, you know, Shane McMahon and with, you know, Undertaker, you know, scared to death. And then he tells me, he's like, Maven, you're going to come in and eliminate him. And I thought he was completely joking. I thought it was the rib of the century. I'm like, yeah, whatever. Well, then Taker turns, looks at me, and says, and I'm sorry, he goes, are you effing kidding me? And at that point, I wanted to run. I wanted to just leave. But come to find out, it was, I think, you know, Taker had his hands in that being what was going down for that day, you know. So he helped my career more than anyone on that single day.
That's amazing. So that was that's the initial reaction. We're going to get into the nuts and bolts of what actually happened, but what were those conversations like with Taker after the fact? Was everyone happy with how it was received?
And that's, you know, I mean, you know wrestling enough to know that you don't have a good match unless both guys are pleased with what took place out there. So my biggest concern was making sure he was happy with the performance I did. I mean, green, extremely green, not knowing what I was doing out there, and with literally a legend. I mean, you know, it's like if I walked out there and all of a sudden was around Joe Montana, Tom Brady, Lawrence Taylor, and all at the same time. That's what Taker is in the wrestling business. He is, you know, a legend. So to make sure that things were good in his eyes was all I was concerned with. And, you know, he was. And he was happy. And from that, you know, that day on, me and him had a kind of a bond, I guess you would say. He always gave me that smile, that, you know, that little, hey, kid, you know, look. And let me know that that what I did was he was satisfied with.
Awesome. Well, you say that was like the ultimate, like, pinch me moment of your career. You had just won Tough Enough 3 months prior, which was incredible, but that had to be like that, the pinch me. This isn't real.
The ultimate pinch me moment. It was one of those moments that you ever have a day when you go home and when you lay down to go to bed that night, you're replaying the day in your head and you still can't believe what took place. That was that day. And then I was getting, you know, calls. You know, this was back in the early cell phone days, so all my buddies in Cincinnati were using my anytime minutes. And they were calling me up, telling me how good they thought it came out on TV. And once, you know, once I saw that they were pleased with it, once I saw Taker and you know, Shane and Vince and everybody was pleased with it, then, you know, I was like, this is, I'm where I need to be. I can do this.